Let us see the next topic, derangements. Let us see the definition. A permutation of n distinct objects in which none of the objects is in its natural place is called derangement. Now let us take an example. Consider 1, 2, 3. Now we are going to write the derangement of this order. Let us see what is that. That means derangement is a permutation of three objects. Now we are going to see three objects in which none of the objects is in its natural place. Natural means in its original place. Let us see. Derangements are 2 is in the first place, but here 2 is in the second place. Here we have taken in the second place, so 2 is not in the original place. Now here 3, we have taken 3 is in the second place, but originally it was in third place. So 3 is in second place, it was originally in third place. So 3 is not in its original place. When you go for 1 also, 1 has come in third place, but originally it was in first place. So we can say this is a derangement because it is a permutation in such a way that none of the objects are in its original place. None of the objects are in its original place. So this is a derangement. Now let us see one more derangement. We can write 3 in the first place, 1 in the second place, 2 in the third place. See, again if you compare these elements with this original, none is in the original place. See, 3 is in the first place, but here 3 is in the third place. 1 is in the second place, but here 1 is in the first place. And here 2 is in the third place, but here 2 is in the second place. So this is one more derangement where no object is in its original place. Therefore, how many derangements we have got? Number of derangements. One derangement, another derangement. There is no other possibility which we can arrange so that no object is in its original place. There is no other possibility. Only two possibilities we got. Therefore, this D3 represents number of derangements with three elements. So therefore, we can also say the number of possible derangements of n distinct objects, 1, 2, 3, and so on n, is denoted by dn. Here we had three objects, so we have represented d3 as the number of possible derangements with three elements is 2. Here only two arrangements are there, two derangements. So this is the definition of derangement. The formula for dn, for n greater than or equal to 1, let us see the formula. That is how many derangements we will be having for n elements, where n is greater than or equal to 1. The formula is n factorial into this series. This series can be written in the short form as, with the help of summation symbol, summation from k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 to the power k divided by k factorial. We can write this. If you expand this by taking the values of k from 0 to n, you will get back this. But what is this? This is of the form e to the power minus 1 expansion. This is nothing but the expansion of e to the power minus 1. For n greater than or equal to 7, now let us write dn is approximately same as floor function of n factorial into e to the power minus 1. This is e to the power minus 1, which is approximately equal to, if you calculate in your scientific calculator what is the value of 1 by e, the value of 1 by e will be this into n factorial we have written as it is. So from here onwards, if your n is greater than or equal to 7, directly we can apply this formula to find the number of derangements with n elements. That is, n is greater than or equal to 7. Now here, for example, find the number of derangements of 1, 2, 3, 4. You can have many derangements here, and you can find out how many number of derangements are there. Second example, evaluate D5, D6, D78. Yeah. So let us take the problem. While at a race track, there is a race track. There is a race track. And so on. A person bets on each of the 9 horses. There are nine horses, and so on. There are 9 horses in a race to come in accordance to how they are favored. He has bet that this horse will be in the first place, this horse will be in the second place, this horse will be in the third place, and so on, up to 9th place he has bet on 9 horses. Now, the question is, in how many ways can they reach the finish line? In how many ways can they reach the finish line so that he loses all his bets? When he loses all his bets, if the horse which he bet as in the second place is not going to come in the second place, and the horse which he bets as in the first place is not going to come in the first place, and the horse which he bets as in the third place is not going to come in the third place, and so on. That means none of the horses are going to satisfy his bets. That means none of the horses are going to come in their original places as he expected. That means number of derangements we need to find. Number of derangements we need to find. Now let us go for the solutions. Here we have to find the number of ways of arranging the horses. Let us label the horses as 1 to 9 as the bets, first place, second place and so on, so that 1 is not in its favored place. The horse, the first horse is not in its favored place, whatever he has bet, the horse 1 is not going to come in the its original place, favored place. 2 is not in its favored place and so on. 9 is not in its favored place. Thus the required number of ways is the number of derangements, of 9 objects, namely. Now let us see in how many ways he is going to lose the bets. That is given by D9. D9 means number of derangements of 9 objects. The formula is, since this 9 is greater than or equal to 7, we can apply this formula is into n factorial. In the place of n factorial, we have taken 9 factorial. If you use your scientific calculator and solve this, you will get this answer. That means these many ways he will lose his bets. Let us consider the next problem. There are n pairs of children's clothes in a box. Each pair is of a different color. Now in a box there are n pairs of one pair, second, third and so on. There are n pairs of gloves in a box. Now what is the other condition? Each pair is of different color. This is blue color, red color and so on, different colors. Suppose the right gloves are distributed at random to n children. Suppose there are n number of children. There are n number of children. What they are saying? The right gloves are distributed at random to n children. Suppose this gloves has been given to this, and this gloves, right gloves, has given to this, and so on, and so on. And thereafter, the left gloves are also distributed to them at random. After this arrangement, the left gloves is also going to distribute. Now, what is the condition there? What let us see. They want to find the probability that no child gets a matching pair. At the time of distributing the left glove, is not going to get the matching pair. No child gets a matching pair when the left gloves is distributed. And also we need to find the probability that every child gets a matching pair. What is the chance that every child gets a matching pair? And what is the probability that exactly one child gets a matching pair? Exactly only one child. Next is, what is the probability that at least two children get matching pair? Let us solve one by one. Any one distribution of n right gloves to n children determines a set of n places for the n pairs of gloves. Let us take these as the natural places for the pairs of gloves. After distributing the n right gloves, let us consider those places as natural places. The left gloves can be distributed to n children in n factorial ways. Because we have n left gloves. If you distribute n left gloves among n children in how many ways? N factorial ways you can distribute. See, this is the total number of ways of distributing n left gloves among n children. Now first sub-question, the probability. What is the event here? The event of no child getting a matching pair occurs if the distribution of the left gloves is a derangement. This happens only when the distribution is a derangement. No child is getting a matching pair means what? It is a derangement. No left gloves is going to its original place. That means a derangement. Now what is the probability of such a thing? Probability is always defined as favorable cases divided by total number of cases. This is total number of cases. Now how do we find the favorable cases? Favorable cases is nothing but number of derangements. Let us find the number of derangements. The number of derangements is denoted by Dn. It is simple. It is Dn. Therefore, the required probability in this case is, how do we write? Number of derangements, that is number of favorable cases divided by total number of cases, total number of ways of distribution. Let us simplify it further. This is Dn, as we already know here, we will write divided by n factorial. But what is the formula for Dn? Let us write down. It is n factorial into this series. Now what happens? N factorial gets cancelled. This will remain. So this completes the first case, first sub question. Now let's see the second sub question. The event of every child getting a matching pair is only one distribution, because every pair has got different colors. So how many possible ways of distributing the left gloves among the children? It is only one possibility. So therefore number of favorable cases is one. Therefore the required probability in this case is number of favorable cases divided by total number of cases. How many favorable cases are there? Only one. Total number of cases, n factorial. So this is the solution for the second sub question. Let us go for the third sub question. The event of exactly one child, only one child, getting a matching pair occurs only when one left clause is in the natural place and all others are in the wrong places. That means the number of such distributions is Dn minus 1, because we have one child getting a matching pair. If you remove one from n pairs, n gloves, you'll get n minus 1. And they are asking exactly one should get matching pair, the other should not get a matching pair at all. That means number of such cases are Dn minus 1. Therefore, the required probability in this case is favorable cases are these. These are the favorable cases. That means n minus 1 children are getting unmatching pairs, unmatching left clause. Therefore, it is the probability is equal to favorable divided by total. Favorable is this, Dn minus 1 by n factorial. But what is Dn minus 1? Let us see, expand. Dn minus means n minus 1 factorial. Wherever n was there, n minus 1 will come into picture. Wherever n is there, n minus 1 will come. Therefore, after cancellation, because we can write down this n factorial as n into n minus 1 factorial, we can eliminate this n minus 1 factorial. What remains is this. So this is the answer for the third sub question. Now fourth one, the event of at least two children getting a matching pair occurs if the event of no child or one child getting a matching pair does not occur. What does this mean? Event of at least two children getting a matching pair. That means two children may get matching pair, at least means this. Or three children may get matching pair, four children may get matching pair, five, and so on. That means the case of zero children getting a matching pair does not exist, and the case of exactly one child getting a matching pair does not exist. So that means from the universal set, I need to remove this. The probability of universal set is 1. Now we need to remove minus of the probability of this case and the probability of this case. Let us see how do we write this. The probability in this case is 1 minus of P1 plus P3. P1 plus P3. Because here no child gets a matching pair should not be there, and one child getting a matching pair does not occur. So P3 was that event, and P1, let us go back. See here, exactly one child getting a matching pair. Oh, it is your P3. We don't want this case in the fourth sub question. When we go back to the first case, let us go and see. Here, no child, see, no child getting a right pair, the probability is P1. So this is what we need to remove, P1 and P3 from 1. Let us conclude our answer. Therefore, the required probability is 1 minus P1 plus P3. So this completes our solution. This one, there are 8 letters to 8 different people. There are 8 letters to 8 different people to be placed in 8 different addressed envelopes. That means there are 8 letters to be put in 8 different envelopes. And so on. What they are asking, find the number of ways of doing this so that at least one letter gets to the right person. At least one letter should get to the one right person. At least one means, at least one means one or more than one letter. At least one means what? One or more than one letter gets to the right person. That means we need to exclude the case that no letter exclude the case that no letter gets to the right person. No letter gets to the right person. So in total number of cases, if you exclude this case, if you remove this case, you will get this number. You will get this number. Let us see. What is this case? This is derangement. So we need to remove number of derangements. Number of derangements, if you remove, you will get to know how many such possibilities exist. The number of ways of placing 8 letters in 8 envelopes is 8 factorial. This is the total number of placing the 8 letters in 8 number of envelopes. 8 factorial ways are there total. Now, the number of ways of placing 8 letters in 8 envelopes such that no letter is in the right envelope is D8. That is what we don't want. We want at least one letter. At least one letter should go to right person. That means we don't want such a case. No letter is in the right envelope. We don't want such a case. Therefore, if you remove this number from 8 factorial, that is 8 factorial, from 8 factorial, if you remove this D8, you will get the answer. Let us see. Therefore, the number of ways of placing 8 letters in 8 envelopes such that at least one letter is in the right envelope is 8 factorial minus D8. total number of possibilities minus the case where no letter is going to the right person. If you remove, you will get the cases where at least one letter is going to the right person. Now let us apply the formula. 8 factorial minus this d8. If you simplify this, you will get here we have taken 8 factorial as common factor. We have taken 8 factorial as common factor. You get 1 minus e to the power minus 1 here. Now if you further simplify, you will get this. Further simplification will give. Therefore, floor of this integer is this. So these many ways are there where at least one letter goes to the right person. So this completes the problem.